Spring is a busy time on the farm. First, the ground has to be plowed. After the plowing, the ground has to be tilled in preparation for planting. Oats must be planted early. The drill which does the planting is loaded with the seed oats in one compartment and the fertilizer in another. Another kind of planter is used for planting corn. Fertilizer is poured into the yellow hoppers. Weed killer is used to hold back the weeds until the corn is high enough for cultivation. The seed corn is put in the galvanized hoppers. The planter is equipped with a marking device, which is used as a guideline for the next trip around. There are three principal types of hay: clover, alfalfa, and timothy. The bobolink scolds as its nesting grounds are invaded. Missy Skunk takes off to find herself a new home, but Mr. Woodchuck plans to stay. The hay is crushed to speed up the drying process and raked into rows for the baler. The hay is transferred to the loft on an elevator and stored until it is needed to feed the animals. Like all competitive businessmen, farmers are looking for newer and more efficient machines to help them in their work. This machine mows, crushes, and rakes the hay in one operation. Weather is an important factor in the business of farming. The farmer wonders when the rain will come to revive the corn and the dry pastures. And sometimes the farmer gets more rain than he needs. Getting the corn planted is not the end of the work. It must be cultivated until it gets too high for the cultivator to get through the rows. In spite of the modern farming methods, weeds still are a problem. Wheat and oats ripen at about the same time, and both are harvested with the combine. This machine cuts the stalks and shells out the grain. The grain falls into a bin on the combine and the straw falls to the ground. The grain is unloaded into a hopper from where, by means of a blower, it is transferred to storage bins. The straw, which is left over from harvesting the grain, is baled in the same manner as hay. The clover, which was planted with the wheat, now begins to grow and will be harvested the following year. The straw is stored and used as bedding for the animals. When the goldenrod is in bloom and the corn is still green, it is time to cut the corn for silage. The corn is harvested in the field with a mechanical chopper. The corn stalks are cut into short lengths by the chopper and transferred to the truck by a blower. When the truck is full, it is driven to the silo and dumped. The conveyor feeds the chopped corn into a blower, which forces the corn through a pipe to the top of the silo. The spout of the blower pipe directs the chopped corn to a revolving deflector plate, which distributes the corn evenly in the silo. Once the silo is filled, the silage is used for feed for the cattle through the winter and the early spring. The silage is dropped down the chute to the feeding station, which becomes a favorite hangout for the cows. The chopped corn is distributed along the feeding troughs by means of an auger conveyor. In the fall, the silage is sweet and green. As the time goes by, the silage ferments, but this does not affect its value as cattle feed. In fact, the cows seem to relish the more tangy flavor. Mechanization in the feeding of cattle is one more step in increasing the efficiency of the American farmer. In the latter part of September, the ground is prepared for planting of wheat. After the drill has been loaded with fertilizer, the wheat seed and clover seed are poured into separate compartments. The wheat planted in the fall will be harvested the next summer, but the clover will not be harvested until the following summer. Corn is harvested in late October with a mechanical corn picker. The corn picker is a standard combine with a special attachment which picks and shells the ears of corn. The shell corn falls into a bin and the cobs are discarded. Corn must be dried before it is stored. Today's farmer dries corn in a propane-fired grain dryer. The harvested corn is dumped into a trough and transferred to the bottom of the grain dryer by means of an auger. A second auger keeps circulating the corn while heat from the propane flame is forced through the corn with a blower. The level of the grain in the dryer drops about a foot due to shrinkage as the grain dries. The dry grain is loaded into a wagon and transferred to a bin for storage. Some of the corn is picked without being shelled. The unshelled ears of corn are stored in ventilated cribs and allowed to dry naturally. After the corn is picked, the stalks remaining are chopped and plowed under the next spring. With the harvest completed, the traditional day of thanksgiving for the bounty of nature is celebrated by the farmer.